Hey guys, it's Nikki and I'm back again with another video for you today. And this one is exciting because there was a lot of preparation for it. So, I'm doing a DIY bohemian jewelry video for you guys today. And I'm so excited because like this video is also like very me. Like this is my style and I wear these pieces and like absolutely adore them. Like since I made them like half a week ago. And I've just like been wearing them like crazy and people are like, what the heck? Like, did you make those? And I'm like, yeah, I did. And now I'm passing on my information to all of you. It's great. So there's gonna be two parts to this video. The first part is like how I constructed them and where I got the pieces and how you can make them yourselves. And then the second half of the video is how to wear them with each other, not so much like with outfits, because as you can tell, I'm only wearing a white t-shirt so that all of these pieces will match what I'm wearing. It's also very cold out, so like, this is pretty cool of me to do. Yeah. So I've divided the necklaces. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 that I'm showing you. It's pretty perfect. I've divided them into like 3 different styles. I have the ones that are pretty simple, the ones that are like stones and like classy or like nicer ones, and the ones that are just like all out boho. So let's get started on the classier side of things. I need to stop talking with my hands. okay, so this first one, pendant A, this one right here, oh god, I'm gonna be out of focus this entire video too, this is gonna be a problem for me. This beautiful pendant, I don't know how to do this, honestly. There it is. This pendant is honestly just gorgeous, like, it's like china glass. And it's just so classy and it's beautiful. And I bought it at Michael's Craft Store. Actually, everything I bought today has been from Michael's Craft Store. And I put it on this silver chain that I've had for a long time. And it's just gonna be so pretty to just sit on my chest with like a beautiful white dress in the summer, or a white tank top, or blue something or other. But it's just gorgeous and I can't wait to wear it. I'll probably honestly wear this with my dress on Thanksgiving. It kind of reminds me of like a grandma necklace, but like it's something that you like acquire from like your ancestors, but I really like it anyway. This next pendant that I got is my birthstone and it is amethyst. And it's honestly just like gorgeous. It's all chunky and like broken up and I love that about it. And then the actual wire detailing on it is really pretty too. This one's a little pricier. I want to say it was like $15. And then what I did was I bought a long piece of silver chain that I think was honestly like two or three feet long. It was long and I used it for another necklace, which I'm going to show you next too. And there's no clasp on it. So what I had to do was buy a jump ring. And when I just cut the wire, I put a jump ring on it. So this has to slip over my head, which it casually does. And I'm not pulling it under my hair, but it falls to about where my low-cut shirts start, and that was because I wanted it to be that length. You could just cut it to whatever length you want, but I like this one, and I'm done talking about it. And last but not least, for the, what did I call them, like the classy jewelry, I got this pendant. Let's zoom in on it. And I do not know what this is, maybe like a rose quartz or something. That looks kind of right. It's very like cut into like a pendulum style, and it's like very light pink, like rosy, and then it's got the beautiful silver detailing up the top. And again, I cut the chain. This one's much longer. This one goes to like the tip of it. This part right here touches my belly button, so this one's really long. And yeah, I cut the chain, and then I put a jump ring on it, and bam, you got yourself a nice dangly long pink necklace. That's what it is. Okay, and now on to the second set of jewelry that I have. These are the simpler pieces that really don't take much to make at all. Not that those last ones were very difficult, but these ones you just can basically throw on with anything. This first one is a brown felty type clasp that I bought from Michael's, and it's got like a little clasp at the top and everything. But the pendant that I chose to buy for it is this Kuan Yin, like aged silver looking one. And what it is, it's, oh no, that's not even Kuan Yin. Shoot, I actually don't know what god this is. I have a Kuan Yin one coming up. I have a Kuan Yin and two Buddhas to show you guys. But no, I actually don't know what god this is, so I'm sorry about that, but it's like the elephant god, I just forget the name. And they're sitting in front of like a lotus looking type flowery tree thing. It's very pretty and I like it, and I'm gonna wear it with some sundresses at some point because I'm going to Florida soon, so that's what's gonna happen. And then the next two that I got are chokers that I made myself. So I bought, like the chain that I showed you before, I bought a ton of just black, like it's like felty like type material. It's not felt, it's thicker than that. It's like rope almost. I don't know what this is, honestly. I'm gonna stop trying to describe it. But it was long, like I don't know how, this one was probably like 5 feet. No, not 5 feet, that's a lot. Maybe even 5 feet worth of fabric. And I cut it to the length that I wanted. So this one, yep. Okay, let's just, excuse me right now. Goes like this, and then bang, and on it we have a little shark tooth, I would say. I think that's a shark tooth. I might be out of focus. But I like it a lot. And then the next one I got was, it's the exact same thing, but it's an Om symbol, which basically is my entire life. I'm way too into it. I love Om, so I had to have that, and I really like it, and I'm glad I bought it. On to set number three. Can you believe we actually made it this far? So, these are my extremely boho. You might not like these if you're not into this style. Look, that was a terrible way to describe something. That made it sound so unappealing. These are my favorite ones. This one I've had forever, but I decided to throw it in because like it is the epitome of like bohemian style. So I was like, yeah, I mean, I have to. So it's this rope thingy. What's this called? Like the actual necklace. It's not chain, rope. And it's got the little like ball connector at the top. I don't know if you can see that, where is it? Right here. And then I got an amethyst stone, which the amethyst stone I did get from Michaels, but the rope necklace part, I don't know where I got it from, it's very old. But I'm throwing this in here because when I was at Michaels this week, I did actually see similar thing, like just like a little rope that you can use. And you buy the pendant and you wedge it on there. This was not easy to get on, but it was worth it, and I wear this constantly. It's so worn out, but I like it that way, because I've worn this in water, like doing like weird things, like just, it's gotten very, very dirty over the years, but I like it that way. So, next up, this is a rubber cord, and it does this. Yeah, it's awesome. And I bought a little Buddha. And alongside the two Buddhas, the one Buddha, I have some little white beads that I bought, and then these chrome that match him, like perfectly, they're the exact same color. Chrome little like circles that I also got, they were like in this long string, and you just like bought it. I think it was like $2 or something for all of them. And I only wanted like part of the like bead set in the string, so I just like cut them out and I put them on. And then the white beads came with brown beads, and they were in a box, like a little plastic tin. And they were all really cheap. Like I have a ton of excess beads upstairs that I'll probably use for other jewelry in the future. But so you just kind of do whatever little set, like whatever mix of beading you want. And then this is pretty short, but I like it. So that is how that looks on me. And like I said, this is stretchy. I mean, it's not like you can like stretch it out long, it still pops short. But it's like nice material, and then if you stretch it too much, I mean, I'm not gonna say it couldn't break, but just be careful, you know? Let's be good about it. Next up, I have a very similar thing, same cord. I call this Buddha 2.0 because everything about the last necklace is just a simpler version of this necklace. Bear with me, this cord tends to twist and it's quite frustrating. Luckily, it doesn't do when you're wearing it. We got Mr. Buddha here. Okay, so I've got the big Buddha pendant, which I absolutely love, and then some white beads and the same chrome circles, but I also bought these little wooden gems. They came in another string, and I just cut them out. I don't remember, I think these just came like as they were. I don't think there was anything else in it that I didn't like keep or want. But with the rubber thing, the rubber necklace, you've got to make sure when you're buying beads to go with it that they will fit because it's a little thicker. Luckily the ending on one side is pretty much the same width, so if you think you can get it around the whole thing, you should be able to get it on. But yeah, that was a struggle. I came home and I was like, darn it, a lot of these beads don't even fit on it, and I was just like... But so, the last necklace that I got is this one, and this is the Kuan Yin that I was telling you about. There she is, Kuan Yin. Yeah, she's like white, and I like that because all my ones are brown. She almost looks like kind of like as if it was carved from like a big animal, like husk or tooth. Like that's like the type of material it is. But it's like obviously very soft, and like it's like painted out of the lines on purpose. It's really pretty. It's like rustic. Like rustic looking, like the style, not the actual raw style. I don't know that. But and then a huge letdown is to tell you that I didn't make this. This is a necklace that I bought like this, but it's extremely easy to make. You just get some beads and you string them, but I wanted one that was all beaded, so I got this one. And this is how she looks. It's also pretty short. Let me see, I can show you. It's not a very long necklace, but again, I like it. Look, it fits like so nice. It's pretty close. Boom, she good looking. On to part two of the video, which is hopefully a little more informative and helpful than the first half, which was pretty difficult to get through, honestly. I'm gonna show you how I put some of these together. And this is the most exciting part because I never just wear one. I mean, like, I wear one of them if I want to. But they look so good together, and you can like mix and match different of like the three styles that I showed you, or stick with like one, and I'm still talking with my hands. But they're just like beautiful pieces and they really make an outfit. Like I love simple clothing, and then I'm just like bang with the jewelry, you know? Does that happen for you too? Okay. Sticking to the wall, sticking to this one-way street. You can never run, but you said you'd run with me. There you have it. That's all the jewelry that I've made recently and how I would wear it together. Obviously I didn't show you all the combinations. Basically, like, if you think it looks okay, it's okay. And it's probably great, actually. It doesn't really matter. You can do it however you want, as long as you like it like that. So, I'm really excited to keep wearing these and making more and showing you guys. So if you like this video, be sure to let me know. This is my first DIY. And I love to do this. Like, I do this all the time. I've just, like, never thought to, you know, tell people about it. It's kind of selfish of me, so I'm sorry. Thank you for bearing with me here. A little all over the place. I just woke up. So, that was fun, though. And I'm gonna stop talking. I will see you guys again soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.